Hi, this is Ajay Judgi. Today we shall discuss about a device that is called as a GPS. GPS is nothing but a global positioning system. We shall consider a device L80. You may consider other device also. Most of the GPS receivers are using the same protocol. Okay, that is nothing but NMEA 0183. What is NMEA 0183? That is nothing but a National Marine Electronic Association. Okay. So this we shall be using. Okay. So when I discuss about the device L80, it looks like this. Okay. So many other devices also supporting the same protocol. Okay. Let us consider the features of the GPS receiver first. Okay. So very first we shall consider the power supply. Okay. It may operate on 3 volt or it may operate on 4.3 volt. But we shall be going with a typical power that is nothing but a 3 volt. Okay. The current consumption of a GPS receiver may be 25 milliampere. Okay. And next feature is a receiver type. It is a GPS L1 1575.42 megahertz. Okay. So it can operate with 66 search channels and 22 simultaneous tracking channels. This is the feature, important feature of the GPS receiver. And next feature of a GPS receiver is its sensitivity. It can be around 165 dBm. Okay. The beauty of this L80 or some other GPS receiver is that it has onboard patch antenna. Okay. It has a onboard patch antenna. We are not supposed to connect an external antenna for operation. Okay. So we shall be going with a recommended minimum specific GPS transmit data. What is this? This is nothing but a $GPRMC. We shall be dealing with this. Okay. So what is this? When I connect, now we shall see how to connect the GPS to the microcontroller. Okay. So we shall see before we go for the details how to interface a GPS with microcontroller. This we shall see. Okay. The answer is through UART 8N1. Okay. What is 8N1? 8 means 8 data bits. Okay. N means no parity. Okay. 1 means 1 start bit and 1 stop bit. Okay. What? 1 start bit and 1 stop bit. Okay. And we shall be connecting this GPS receiver with microcontroller at the baud rate 9600. Okay. How it looks like? It if I consider L80 as a GPS receiver, it looks like this. Okay. And this is a pin configuration. Okay. This is a pin configuration of a GPS receiver, that is L80. Okay. So there are so many pins around. If I start counting, this is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 and 12, but we are interested only in ground. Okay. So whatever number of grounds we have, that all have to be connected to the grounds. Okay. And the VCC here, typically we have to connect around 3 volt as a power supply. Okay. And from this pin number 2, we shall be taking the output. Okay. Here we shall be taking the output, and this output will be connected to the input of your microcontroller. Okay. Input means that will be connected to UART RX. Okay. That will be connected to UART RX of your microcontroller, since it is compatible with the UART communication. Okay. Now we can see the application of the applications of various applications of the GPS receiver. Okay, where we can use this. Okay, the first application is navigation system. All we know. Okay, we can use this in our cars. That can be used in your mobile phones. Okay, that even that can be a portable device which can be used for the navigation. Okay, which gives the exact location or a correct location of the information about the correct location of the person or a device. Okay. The next application is asset tracking. Okay. If you are having some very valuable asset, then you can track with continuously by putting GPS along with it. Okay. Then it can be used in security systems. Okay. It can be used in air. Okay. That can be used in drones or some other applications or aerial applications. Now we shall see how the data has to be processed. Okay. How the data has to be processed. Suppose when I connect a GPS receiver, when I connect a GPS receiver to a microcontroller using UART, okay, what I get? I get this all. Okay, this is what I receive. Okay, this is what I receive. This continuous data I receive. Okay, then what I have to do? I have to create. Okay, I have to create some array. Okay, I have to create some array, and I have to store this entire data. This all data, I have to store into some array. Okay, then I have to process this array so that I can extract a desired field from this. Okay, what can be the desired fields? Let us consider the latitude. I need to understand what is my current location. Okay, if this is the data that I'm receiving from my GPS receiver. Okay, let us consider this is the data I'm continuously receiving from my GPS receiver. Okay, now I have to process this data, and I have to understand what is my location. That means simply I have to understand what is my latitude and what is my longitude. Okay, so here the first field that I have here, that is named with 1, that is nothing but you can see easily that is nothing but a timestamp. This is the timestamp that simply gives me the time. Okay, so from this you can understand the time, that is nothing but 22:05:16. Okay, this may be my time. Okay, from the first field I can understand what is the time. Okay, now the second field is A. What is A? A is nothing but if I get the letter A along with the GPS data at this position, that means I'm getting a valid data. I'm getting a valid data. If it would have been V, then the data would have been invalid. Okay, so what is the third field? Third field I have, this is my third field. Okay, this is my third field. Okay, so that is nothing but my current latitude. Okay, this may be my current latitude. Okay, then what is N? N is nothing but a fourth field. Fourth field is nothing but it may be a direction, north or south. Okay, let us move further. The fifth field, that is having 00042.24. okay, so this is my current longitude. Okay, this is going to be my current longitude. Okay, so if I move further, then there is a sixth field, that is a W. Okay, and that is again a direction, east or west. Okay, when I move further, I get a seventh field, that is 173.8. okay, so this is my seventh field, 173. okay, that is nothing but a speed in knots. Okay, that can also measure a speed or velocity. Okay, now if I move to the eighth field, I'm getting that is 231.8. okay, the eighth field is 231.8. that is nothing but a true course. Okay, you're not supposed to worry about this. That is not so much useful for you people. Okay, then I have to move for a ninth field. Ninth field is nothing but a 130.630.694. okay, this is nothing but a date stamp. Okay, that is nothing but a date stamp. Okay, so this is going to be my date stamp, and from this easily you can understand what is it. Okay, then as I move for a 10th field, okay, this is what I get as a 10th field, that is nothing but a variation. Okay, 11th field, from this also you can understand that is nothing but a direction again, and the 12th bit is nothing but a checksum. Okay, so this is all about the what data we get from the GPS receiver. Okay, so when you will be programming this, as I said, you have to get all this information, you have to gather all this information from GPS, that you have to store into the an array, and then you have to process it. For example, suppose we have discussed all the fields, okay, and their significance also. Now suppose if I need to extract the latitude and longitude, what I have to do? I have to very first search the dollar and GPRMC, because these fields may be different, because you are not going to get only this much data. You may be getting different type of data also, but what you have to do? You have to search the dollar GPRMC first. Okay, then you have to travel along this array. Okay, you have to keep on counting these letters. Okay, and you have to locate the latitude. Okay, here in case of your, here in our case the latitude is this. Okay, so we have to travel along this array and we have to find out this latitude. Okay, then again we have to move further, and so that we can find out the longitude. Okay, sorry, this is a longitude, okay, this is a longitude, that's a mistake, okay. So here we have a current latitude, okay. You have to move along this, okay, and you have to find out this. This is your latitude, okay, this is your latitude, okay. Again, you have to move along this, and this is going to be your longitude, okay. This is going to be your longitude, okay. These two things can be, these two data can be stored in different arrays. So let us call them as a, say, lati, okay. If I want to store the latitude, I can make some array and I can store that in some array with the name lati, and I can store this with the name, say, longi, okay. From this easily we can understand what is my current location, okay, from latitude and longitude. If you are interested in other things, only you have to worry about whenever you are processing the data, you should have alphabet A here. That means whatever data you are getting, that is valid, okay. Then if you are interested in a timestamp, or if you are interested in a speed or other parameters, easily you can move along with this array and you can exactly locate the number that you want, and you can process your own data. This is all about the GPS interfacing or GPS receiver, okay, how to interface that, how to process the data, okay. If you want more videos, you can subscribe my channel, and if you like, you can share with your friends. Thank you very much.